Did you know that 42% of startups fail because they don't meet the market needs? That's what happens when you count your chickens before they hatch, or in this case, when you count your users before they love your product. Hello and welcome back to our second episode of our real series on 10 dysfunctions of product management. Today we'll talk about counting house trap, where product teams get obsessed with internal numbers and forget about the customer. A classic example of a company that fell into counting house trap is Sears. Sears is one of the largest department store chains in United States. One of the main reasons for decline of Sears is this obsession with a metric called same store sales. Same store sales measures the revenue impact of retail stores that have been opened for at least a year, excluding newly opened or closed stores. By focusing solely on same store sales, Sears neglected the changing needs of its customers. Especially when online shopping was booming, Sears was slow to adopt digital transformation. And instead, it chose to make short-term decisions like cutting costs and offering discounts to boost same-store sales metrics. As a result, their stores lost their appeal and customers turned to their competitors Walmart and Target, which provided better online and offline shopping experience. Sears filed its bankruptcy in 2018 and learned the hard way that success lies in understanding the customer's needs and changing with time. So how can you avoid counting house trap? The key is to ask yourself, how can you effectively deliver greater value to our customers? If you answer this question and build your business model around it, all the internal metrics will follow the suit. That's it for today's episode. If you like this deal, please follow our page for more content on product businesses. And stay tuned for the next episode where I'll talk about the ivory tower trap. Thank you for watching and see you in the next deal.